come see it.
The thing that I love about you being an emerging artist in the world is that there are these great beacons of light in your career, and then in between, there are those spaces where things get lost, and there's a lot of room for mythology, but I want to clear some of that up.
Mm-hmm.
Let's work backwards. Wasn't it a music video director who initially reached out to you that prompted you to get engaged with a musical project?
Yeah, it was this director slash photographer, and we just kind of started working together, and we're friends, and he was like, can you sing? I was like, I don't know, kind of. So he basically sat me down at a table and was like, write a song. I was like, okay. So wrote some songs, and yeah, it was just this kind of like natural, everything really happened kind of like naturally, one flowed into the other, and then I was like, whoa, all of a sudden I was here.
When you're an emerging artist and you're working on establishing your own creative narrative, and you get to sort of set the tone for how people view you, to some people, it may look like you hatched out of an egg when Vanessa Beecroft cast you, but really, you've had a lifetime of experience with music.
Yeah, I went to this little performing arts school in Arizona, and everyone, like, has to do something in the arts. So I played the oboe and saxophone and sang in choirs, and I never thought that I was going to do music, funny enough, though. Like, I didn't move to LA to do music or anything. It just kind of happened.
Talking about women's rights and sexuality, these are things that are very important to you.
Mm-hmm.
At what point did you really sit up and say, all right, this is what I want to make my album about?
Most of the album had already been written. I think it was like around last summer. I had basically the entire album written, and I met with Kanye. He listened to it and he was like, I don't like a lot of it. And I was like, great, cool, cool. So his advice was to make it cooler. And I was like, one second. So I like went away and made it cooler. But he also talked a lot about sentiment and just what people take from your music and what you give them. I think I kind of sat down with it and I was like, what are all these songs about? Like, what is the line through all of them? Because they were written over kind of a large period of time. And the biggest thing to me was about being alone with myself and finding my own femininity. And I think a lot of that was finding comfort in being separate from relationships and family and things like that I had grown up with or that I felt like I needed to have in my life.
Let's talk about Hard to Love.
Mm-hmm.
What is that song about?
That song is about a family member, actually, and just kind of putting your trust in someone and feeling like they let you down every time. It's like loving someone unconditionally, but realizing that it's like one-sided and that you just want like that one time to be like, just don't let me down this time.
Starting now, starting today, if people are listening to Like a Woman for the first time, what is it that you would really love for them to be thinking about?
I think the biggest thing is just that I mean, it's like so many things, but I guess it's just that I'm confident and insecure at the same time, and I'm like okay being alone, and I feel good in myself, and I feel good in my sexuality, and I feel good in my like being as a woman, and I think everything that I do is just driven by making myself feel good.